So the next concept is about the relationship between the edge length and the radius in all the types of a cubic unit cell. So as we have studied, there are three types of a cubic unit cell we can find, that is a simple, BCC, FCC. Okay, as in case of a simple, there will be 8 atoms at the 8 contribution. So what is the contribution that we have discussed? It is 1/8 contribution. Okay, so in case of a BCC, so 8 atoms at the 8 corners and the 1 atom at the center of the body. Okay, that is not shared with any other unit cell. Similarly, in case of a FCC, 8 atoms at the 8 corners and each atom at the each faces. So the contribution of a face atoms will be like a 1/2. So these questions also might appear in your exam. Okay, now as I told, since it's a cubic unit cell, we need to derive the relationship between the edge length and the radius, where repeatedly you have got the questions based on this concept. Okay, what is the relation between the A and R in case of simple, BCC, FCC? So once you get the relation, it is very easy to apply and to find out the values over there in the exam. Okay, so we'll just get to know what is the relation. Okay, so first I'll just go with a simple cubic unit cell. So here the edge length is nothing but the side. Okay, so this side, what is the length of this side? A. So similarly, what is the length of this side? A. Like this, all the sides will be represented by A, which is nothing but the edge length. Okay, similarly, see, I'll take one side over here. Okay, I know the length of this side, that is A. So here what happens, since atoms are at the corners, okay, so I'm drawing two atoms over here, since they are spheres. Okay, so from the center of this atom to this end, can I consider it as a radius? Exactly. Okay, so this is also from this edge to the center of the atom, let us consider this as a R. So the total length of A, or edge length A, is equal to, can I take it as a R plus R? So it is nothing but A is equal to 2R, right? So this is what the relation, A is equal to 2R in case of a simple unit cell. Even I can write it as a is equal to D. What do you mean by D? It's a diameter. As we know, diameter is equal to twice the radius. So from here to here, it is half of the diameter for this atom. Okay, from here to here, it is half of the diameter for this atom. When I consider these two radius, I'm going to get a total diameter, that is A is equal to D. So this is one relation I have to remember, and A is equal to 2R. So even I can write it as R is equal to A by 2. So these three relations are very important in case of a simple unit cell. Okay, A is equal to 2R, R is equal to A by 2. Similarly, in case of a face diagonal, okay, you just see here. So these are the two face diagonals, okay. I need to find out the relationship between the A and R over here, okay. So we know one atom will be at the center of the face, one atom at this corner, at this corner, okay. If I consider this triangle, if I want to get the length of this face diagonal, I need to sum of this value and this one, that is A square plus A square will give the total length of this face diagonal. So that we can apply here. See, the same thing. So I have taken one face, I'll going to write here. Okay, so put one face diagonal. Okay, so this is one sphere and one more here. Okay, so this is like A, B, C. Okay, what is the length of AC? It is 4R. Okay, how 4R? So from here to here, it is half of the sphere radius, and the total length here is 2R, which is nothing but diameter, and from here to here, half of the diameter R. So the length of AC is 4r. It's simply a length, okay, but we need to find out the relationship between the a and r. Okay, now I can consider this triangle like this from here. Okay, so that is in triangle ABC, if I apply the Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So what is the length of AB? It is A. It is A square over here. What is the length of BC? It is A square. Okay, so AC square is equal to 2A square. Okay, so now what is the length of AC? It is 4R whole square. Okay, so if I take the square root of this 4R, I am going to get 2R. Okay, and here is equal to A divided by, this will become root 2. Okay, this is A is equal to 2R by root 2. Okay, so even I can simplify it as 2 root 2 R is equal to A. How it came? So 2, I can write it as a 2 root 2 root 2 R divided by root 2. Root 2 root 2 will get cancelled. So we're going to get 2 root 2 R, that is equal to A. This is the relationship between A and R in case of FCC. Okay, even I can write it as a R is equal to A divided by 2 root 2. This is very important. A is equal to 2 root 2 or R is equal to A by 2 root 2. This is how the A and R related in case of a FCC. Very simple. So you need to remember these two values. Similarly, when it comes to BCC, so here I could find, see, I had to travel from here to here. Okay, so there are two ways how I could travel. One is from here to here I had to move, and then from here to here I had to move, and then from here to here I had to go. Okay, so 3A level I need to cross. A. Okay, there is an another way how from here to here I can travel, and from here to here I can jump directly, right? Okay, so which is easy, from the face diagonal and with this length I can reach here very easily. Agree? Yes. So for that reason, I don't know the length of this face diagonal. Okay, for that reason I need to find out the length of this face diagonal, and by using that one I am going to find out the length of this one and the relation of A and R. How? Is quite simple. This is how I can find out. See, I'll take this triangle first, okay, which is a right angle triangle. By using that one, I'm going to find out the length of AC, and by using this I'm going to find out this triangle. Okay, understood? Now let us consider the triangle ABC. Okay, ABC. So AC square is equal to, okay, AD square and DC square. AD square plus DC square. Clear? Yes. So AC square is equal to, what is the length of AD? It's the edge length of a cubic unit cell. Its value is A square. So what is the length of DC? Again, it's an edge length, so it is A square. So AC square is equal to 2A square. Now I got the value of AC square. Now, actually we want this one. Agree? Okay. So for that reason, I'll take triangle A. Okay. And here E and C. So in triangle A, E, C. Okay. AE square, which includes 3 sphere, okay, is equal to AC square plus EC square. Agree? Yes. So now keep AE square as it is. What is AC square value? 2A square plus what is EC square value, it is A square. So, can I write here it as a 3A square? Yes. Now, what is AE? It's a body diagonal. Very important. It's a body diagonal. Okay. So, body diagonal includes how many? 3 atoms. Okay. So, from here to here it is R. From here to here it is 2R. From here to here it is R. So, can I write here 4R whole square? Yes. So, I'll just solve here. Okay. So, now if I take a root here, 16R square is equal to 3A square. Okay. That is equal to 4 by root 3 R is equal to A. Agree? 4 by root 3 R is equal to A, or R is equal to A root 3 by 4. So, this is the edge length and the radius relation in case of a BCC. Okay. So, simple, it comes A is equal to 2R. BCC, it comes A is equal to 4R by root 3. When it comes to FCC, it is A is equal to 2 root 2R. Very important. So, based on this one, we're going to solve one problem that was asked in NEET exam. Okay. Here, there are two questions based on the concept what I did now. Okay. So, it was asked in 2012 AIPMT exam. Okay. So, question is, a metal crystallizes with a face-centered cubic lattice. The edge length of the unit cell is 408 picometer. The diameter of the metal atom is how much? Okay. So, for this, you should know diameter is equal to twice the radius. This concept. Okay. So, you have to check the question. A metal crystallizes with a FCC. Okay. And the edge length is given. That is, A is given. How much? 408 picometer. What you need to find out? The diameter. So, we need to find out diameter. How much? For this reason, you should know the relationship between the A and R for FCC. So, as we derived, we know that A is equal to 2 root 2 R. Once you know the value, you can substitute very easily. But when you don't know the relation, you need to think again, which takes much time. Okay, where in your exam, you will be having for each question, especially in CET, for each question, you will be having 1 minute and the 1 question like that. Okay. So, here A is equal to 2 root 2 R, especially for the FCC, and what they have told diameter here. Okay, we know diameter is equal to 2R. Okay, here A is equal to 2 and R is nothing but a diameter. So, can I write here D into root 2? Exactly. So, now can I take A divided by root 2 is equal to D? Yes. Now, what is A? They have given 408. So, 408 picometer divided by root 2. What is the value of root 2? It is 1.414. Okay. So, if I solve these two, I'll going to get a value around 288 picometer. Okay. So, that is option C is correct one. Okay. So, when you know the value of these, okay, you can apply and find out very easily within a minute here. Okay. Similarly, there comes one more question. If A stands for the edge length of the cubic system, okay, repeating, if A, which is nothing but edge length, stands for the edge length of the cubic system, that is simple, PCC, FCC, then ratio of the radii of the sphere in this system, we need to write the ratio of the radii of a spheres in this system. So, we know the relation for all the three, which I did now. Okay. So, we know that A is equal to 2R for simple. A is equal to, A is equal to 2 root 2R for FCC. Similarly, A is equal to 4 by root 3R for BCC. You need to find out the relation here. For what? The radius ratio. So, can I write R is equal to A by 2. Similarly, R is equal to A by 2 root 2. Similarly, here R is equal to root 3 A by 4. Okay. So, it is the ratio of a by 2 is 2. So second I have given BCC here. I'll take BCC root 3 a by 4 is equal to. So next one is 1 divided by 2 root 2 a. So do you have this answer in this one? Yes. So the first option itself gives the answer. So when you know the value of these, you can find it very easily. Okay. So these are the two questions related to this concept. I hope you find it easy. So do expect some more videos based on this concept and some more questions we're going to solve. Okay. The CET and the NEET. Do like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.